Dr. Modrak?
Here.
Mr. O'Brien?
Here.
Mr. Rappaport?
Here.
Ms. Zuckerman, here. Mr. Palma?
Here.
Mr. Growl?
Here.
Mr. Parisi?
Here.
Ms. Ammer?
Pledge of allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The New Jersey Open Public Meeting Law was enacted to ensure the right of the public to have advance notice of and to attend meetings of public bodies at which any business affecting their interest is discussed or acted upon. In accordance with the provision of the Act, the Montville Township Board of Education provided a public notice of this meeting, which included time, date, and location, that was posted at the Montville Township Municipal Building, all Montville Public Schools, the Montville Public Library, the Montville Township Board of Education Administrative Office Building, the district website, and advertised in the Daily Record, the board's official newspaper, on February 5th, 2022.
Thank you, Virginia. Aaron, I think it's your right tonight, so why don't you leave us off?
Yeah, unfortunately, I'm really lost your voice, but I will start with the past news. So on December 13th, the NCCE program, Cultural Diversity Club, MTHS Hockey, and the Key Club accepted donations for the annual holiday toy drive where they took unwrapped gifts from students into collection bins. As usual, the event was a great success. For the present news, this week we have MTHS's Winter Spirit Week. There's a different theme each day where students dress up in onesies, holiday characters, and we wear ugly Christmas sweaters on Friday. All this leads to the student faculty basketball game, which everyone is very excited about at the end of the week. And this is a great way for students to head into the holidays. Next, our second annual PE volleyball tournament of champions is heating up, which is a tournament from the qualifying volleyball team from each period of gym. Tomorrow, during lunch, we have the semifinals, and the winner of these games will head into the finals on Thursdays. I will be in the semifinal game, so hopefully I could add that to the news at the next board of meeting if I take the victory. The Montville hockey team already has 3 wins, including the win against Mountain Lakes on TJ Sepsic night, no losses and 1 tie, led by captains Joseph Leno, Matt Howell, and Aiden Engel. Junior Matt Jafar is off to a great start. He leads the team with goals. The team looks forward to playing Parsippany tomorrow. The swim team has a record of 1-2, and they had a meet today against Kinnelon. The girls' basketball team is also off to a hot start. At 3-0, they beat Morristown last night, 61-36, a big win for them. The girls' basketball program has been very strong for years, and this year, led by Grace Kowalski, Katie Gorski, and Carrie Wertheim, it should be another great year. The boys' basketball team faced off against Morristown Knowles last night, led by seniors Patrick Ferrari, Matt Gagliardo, and Andrew Benson. Although the team lost, it was a hard-fought battle. I don't know if any of you guys were there, but it was a great game. They went into double overtime, and they look to bounce back against Roxbury on Friday. Tonight, Marble Wrestling looks to start their season strong off against Del Barton. They travel to Northern Valley Demers on Friday before the holidays. They are led by captains Carl Monaco and Billy Templeton, and the team looks forward to having an amazing season. On to our future events. The students look forward to winter break and heading into a new year. After returning to school, the students will have midterms at the end of January towards the beginning of February. And that's all the news that happened today.
Thank you. Yesterday, you did mention the girls' basketball team. Mr. O'Brien and I were at the game last evening, and it was very, exciting, and it was a runaway, if you will, but Marco's looking very good. I know they have a tough game coming up Friday at Sparta, at home. So they're always a power out of Sparta, so that would be a good indication, but they really are good, and they've got nice support from the stands. I'm sure as the season goes on, more and more people will be able to attend the events, especially since we don't charge now for them to come. But thank you very much for your report. Do we have any questions? Okay, thank you very much, and we'll see you next year. How's that?
Thank you. Happy holidays, everyone.
Same to you.
Thank you.
All right,
Superintendent, sure. Speaking of holidays, so we're going to have some holiday cheer right now.
brought, well, Mr. Fleischman wants to give an introduction, please. Mr. Fleischman is the supervisor of the Digital Performing Arts Department, and is here to introduce to some of our high school students.
Thank you, Dr. Rowan. You, Dr. Rowan, I'm the Board of Education. We have eight outstanding members of our high school music department here today. First up is our wind ensemble, our wind quartet. These students are made up, they're part of our Constitution Band program. They participated in our music concert in 77. Many of them are members of the Tryon Music Honor Society as well, and they sound really good. So let me introduce who they are. We have Jules Zayahoya on flute, Shirley Minoshi clarinet, Joseph Romaniac on alto saxophone, and John Michael Cordillo on trombone. And John Michael, thank you.
All right, so we're going to be playing two songs. Our first song for you tonight is Corral from Jupiter by Gustavo.
Thank you.
That was wonderful. It's a nice send-off for Mr. O'Brien, too, seeing the music. You know, when we talk about, you know, what separates Montville from a lot of other districts, we offer a comprehensive high school that provides, you know, the arts, the athletics, the academics, as well as the activities, and you just see the quality product there. And to think that these kids were, how many years ago, were playing a recorder, you know, and figuring it out, is a real testament to the whole music program and the teachers and the students, many hours they put in, so that was wonderful.
And they all took off.
They're shy.
It was an outstanding performance by them. As we move along in the agenda, the next item is the business administrator's report.
No report.
Jean, there was some good news. It was diverted by our student rep before.
And if I can add, Mr. Graff, Dr. Bill Trusheim is the president of the New Jersey Alliance for Social, Emotional, and Character Development. And what that really ties into, we've heard a lot in Montville about having our schools of character, and he's really the person that's behind it. And it turns out he's a colleague of mine, not through anything I do here, and he does there, but certainly enough, because we have to be trouble players and hand on the works and together. But we were having dinner last night, and she has some very good news with me, which I want to share with everybody. And it says that Montville has been named as the Northern Region Networking Center for the New Jersey Alliance for Social, Emotional, and Character Development. And that Doug Stepp, who's the school counselor at Woodmont School, has agreed to act as the regional coordinator. So he says, Montville and Woodmont are perfect choices because of this district and the school's work in character development over the past years, and that the expectation is that Woodmont is going to host programs for other schools in the northern region of the state. So that's really, really good news. Another feather in the hat to Woodmont, so congratulations to everybody. It really feels good to be able to share that.
Thank you, Michael. And as that fresh time, you used to work with the plumber, didn't you?
He did. He remembers you.
Oh, he does. I'm sure it's only possible, right?
Yes. I said, you know Charlie Brown? He said, everybody knows Charlie
Brown.
He said you were a character.
Actor, Michael. We're right on now. Committee reports, please. Karen?
We had a facilities and finance meeting just before the public session. We talked about our financial health of the district, which is good, and we also talked about some of the facilities projects.
Thank you. Curriculum, Mr. Moffitt? Dr. Moffitt?
No report.
Policy, Mr. Warren?
No report.
Communications, Michelle?
No report.
Safety, Mr. Rappaport?
No report.
Delegates, school boards, Karen?
So, just for everyone's attention, sometime in January, school boards is putting together a podcast entitled, How Do We Keep Out Politicization of the School Board? And it should be a very interesting discussion about things that are happening around us. So that'll be January of 2023. I don't have a time yet. It'll almost certainly be by virtual. Just so everyone knows, for the months of January and February, Morris County School Boards will be all virtual. On December 10th, the Legislative Committee met. We were really pleased to welcome a trio of Assemblywomen, Assemblywoman Caperno, Assemblywoman Buehlner, and Assemblywoman Matsikotis. Assemblywoman Caperno was actually not feeling well, but nevertheless she jumped on the virtual meeting, and all three of them demonstrated a wide range of knowledge in regards to education law and education in the State House. We touched on many issues, including the school funding formula, the 2% cap, inflationary pressures, healthcare costs, Chapter 44, mental health, school and safety, security. It's hard to report, Charlie.
Thank you, Tom. Marsh County School Boards?
I have no report, and I will be devoting my time to going forward to Montville High School Athletic Events in the coming months.
Thank you, Mr. Board. Marsh County Ed Services, Joe?
Had a meeting on the 14th, just going over with the auditors, going to complete their annual financial report, and that meeting on January 11th. We do not reorganize our whole boards due in January, we do that in June. So if I'm staying as the representative, then I'll be there, if not, someone else will stay in my position for that.
Do you have a warning, Joe?
They had a meeting last week, and just were discussing the NFPA has a money contract in their account.
Thank you. Athletic boosters, Mr. Ryan?
The athletic boosters meeting for the calendar was mistaken for December, so it will not be meeting until January.
Thank you, Mike. Liaison, Cedar Hill County?
No report tonight, it's a homeschool meeting in January.
Cedar Hill, no report. Joe, Valley View?
Next meeting's in January.
Christine, Mason?
No report, next meeting is early January.
Woodman,
no report.
Lazar?
No report.
High School?
No report, January 9th is next meeting.
Thank you. Citizens, this is Mark Petrogian, who would like to speak on the agenda. Seeing none, before I entertain a motion for consent agenda, I would like to place a special attention to item K9. K9 is a resolution honoring Mr. O'Brien, and we'll have more to say about that after the consent agenda. And we have a resolution this there that we will read at the end of the meeting. I may have a motion on the consent agenda, please.
So moved.
Second. Any questions on I? J? K? L? M? N? I think that's it. Roll, please.
Dr. Cortolino?
Yes.
Mr. O'Brien?
Yes, I abstain on K9.
Mr. Daughtry?
Yes.
Mrs. Fana?
Yes.
Dr. Modrak?
Yes.
Mr. Rappaport?
Yes.
Ms. Zuckerman?
Yes.
Mr. Palma?
Yes.
Mr. Graff?
Yes. There's no reason to hold a closed session at this point.
I just want to talk about, we have a retiree. So I just want to bring up an hour or two. Yeah, Ms. Revelise is going to be retiring. She's been a dedicated educator at Cedar Hill for nearly 3 decades. During that time, she has had a tremendous impact on the educational advancement of countless students. Ms. Revelise services kindergarten through 5th grade basic skills learners and has always been an icon of collaboration, professionalism, and adaptability. She's a well-rounded teacher where she takes pride in teaching the whole child. Not only focusing on turning their weaknesses into strengths, but also helps to foster and promote self-confidence and resilience in the classroom. We wish her well in retirement.
Thank you.
Tom, can I just say a few words about Joni? Joni, over the course of 30 years at Cedar Hill, became a friend. And she's just the kind of teacher that children gravitate to. So she's not only a great teacher, she's just a warm individual and knows just how to make kids feel good.
Thank you, Karen. Old business, I said at the beginning, it would come back. So on page 6, there's item K9, which says board member resolution. And Mrs. Slunt, I would ask you to read that resolution into the record, please. K9 on page 6.
Whereas Michael O'Brien has been a member of the Board of Education since 2014, and whereas Michael O'Brien provided his input that resulted in the 2017 passage of a successful referendum since the 1990s, earmarked for facilities, renovations, and safety upgrades in the Montville Township Public Schools. And whereas during his tenure, Michael O'Brien was a member of many committees, including Policy and the Finance and Facilities Committee, and a liaison to the Morris County School Boards Association, High School PTC, and Montville Athletic Boosters. And whereas the Board of Education and School District are proud of the accomplishments that Michael O'Brien has made during his tenure, Michael O'Brien has earned a heartfelt thank you and appreciation for all of his contributions to the students of Montville Township. The board and the district wish him well in his future endeavors. And now, therefore, be it resolved by the Montville Township Board of Education of Montville, New Jersey, that a dutifully authenticated copy of this resolution, signed and attested to by the President and Vice President of the Montville Township Board of Education and Business Administrator of the Montville Township Public Schools, be transmitted to Michael O'Brien.
Principal of Montville High School and the first principal
to preside over the term, the new high school, I thought. And for teaching me so much and keeping me with the district, I want to thank Mr. Grau, especially, because over the years, he taught me many things. He taught me that people who were once perceived as opponents could become very good friends and colleagues, mentors and buddies, and I thank him for all of that over the years, and that's heartfelt sincerity. I had an opportunity to teach so many students, an opportunity that a lot of people don't get. And I appreciate this accolade tonight, but there is really a higher accolade that I only achieved in recent months. When I taught biography, I've taught about the lives of great people, and of course, Lincoln was one, and Dr. King. And when I had the opportunity to meet Dr. King as a young man in college, I learned something from him, a very, very important lesson. You all have to have a dream, and one of those dreams, I just achieved that dream very recently. You learn about life, many things, and it's that people can fear you. And like Dr. King, I have always advocated the future, and the future is in public education. And recently, because of the fringe groups and extremist groups that have targeted me in recent months, I realize that the ideas that you carry make people fear you. And that accolade is the most important accolade that I have ever achieved. Like other people of importance, and on a very minimal level, and I appreciate this opportunity to be targeted in such a way. Okay, I would really consider it a high achievement, and I thank you for this honor tonight, and all the other honors and opportunities that Montville has given me. I am one of the luckiest people, as I said, in the world. Thank you very much, Mike. And I know that we're going to be seeing you around as I see you riding your bike or at the ball games. But Mike has been an institution in Montville for many, many years. I know I had four kids go through the high school. Luckily, only two of them had Mike as a teacher. But his contribution to the Board of Education has been second to none. I remember when he was elected, and if he goes back, because back in the 80s, I was the board president at that time, and Mike was president of the association.
That's the 1880s we're talking about.
And we had some discussions during negotiations, and he would get his picture in the paper, I'd get mine in, and we were quoted. And we all had one thing in bottom line, we were here for the kids. And I think we both followed that thought, and it's been great working with you, Mike.
Thank you. Mike, a consummate educator, a consummate board member, and you've taught us so many things. You know, you are one of the most opinionated people I know, but the one thing that separates you from so many people is that you're always willing to state your opinion, but you're also always willing to listen to hear what the other person says. You're always interested in hearing the other person's point of view, because one of the things you taught us all, Mike, nobody ever learned anything by talking. People learn by listening. You've always been a listener. And you've given us your knowledge and wisdom through these years. And you will be greatly, greatly missed. I will always think of you as not only a colleague, but a dear friend. And I wish you nothing but good luck and success for a happy future.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mike.
Karen?
So Mike, you maybe you don't remember this, but the first time that we met, I viewed you at the microphone and you were speaking at the Board of Education. You had your ponytail. And I remember thinking to myself, he's gotta be a great teacher. Lo and behold, in 2014 you came on the board. And there are very few people who can receive the kind of accolades that you're receiving tonight because of all you've done and all you've given to the Board of Education, to the students of Montville, to the community, to the teachers. And I know there are others who want to speak as well. I'll just say we're going to miss you. We're certainly going to miss your sharp humor and your opinions. They're very important. And I wish you well.
Mike, I remember, when I first came on the board, just immediately appreciating the perspective that you have from just being in this district and this community for so many years, wearing so many different hats. And it always really gave a good perspective to all of us. And I just really appreciated listening to what you had to say. And I'm really glad I'll still get to listen to your voice in Mustangs and know that the legacy you've left in the school district is quite impressive and quite appreciated by so many.
Thank you, Michelle. David?
There's very little else I can add, but I do remember coming on this board at the same time with you, Mike, and it's been an absolute pleasure to work with you. I value your honesty and your friendship, and I've never, ever once doubted where your heart was. You were a teacher from the beginning, a teacher, you're still a teacher, and I look forward to seeing your name on an agenda very soon as a substitute teacher here at Montville. You just have a way, you have such knowledge and presence, and you're able to connect with the kids. I mean, the story, some of the stories that he's mentioned about his former students coming up to him and thanking him, and the way he speaks about educating and working with the kids, it's admirable. As I go around, you're always an example that I hold up as someone that we need in this district. And I'm sorry that you're retiring from the board. I wish you all the best, and I look forward to seeing you around.
Thank you, David. Anyone else?
I just want to say, I got to first meet you in 1998 as your student, and you assisted too. And you left an impression on me then. And it wasn't until later on when I got interested in being on the board that I got a chance to see you in a different light, getting to be a colleague of yours. So I wish you the best, and thank you.
Thank you, Joe. Want to grab your board?
Yes, Mike. I first met you when I joined the board 5 years ago. And
I want to repeat everything that all the other board members said, and I agree with everything that they've said. You've done a lot of good work working for the board and the school district, and it's really appreciated. And I personally really appreciate learning so much from you. Since you've been on the board so much longer than I have, hearing your perspective on all the issues that come up when you talk about them, and learning from you about your perspective on how these issues affect the school district and teachers and students is really was very good and really taught me a lot, and I really appreciate that very much. So I personally just want to thank you for your time and effort on the board. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike.
Mike, I want to say exactly what Mike was saying about being on the board and being involved in the school for so long. And a lot of your funny stories that you would tell us at closed door meetings, I will remember. Thank you for your many, many years of service to Montville. When did you first come here? 20 what?
55 years ago.
Wow. So that's a lifetime for some people. So as someone who loves to volunteer, thank you so much for your service, and enjoy your second retirement with your wife and family and grandkids. And I hope to see you at some games. Best of luck.
Thank you. Thank all of my colleagues. I can't thank you enough. I mean it from the bottom of my heart. All of you. And I also see Dr. Renee Broca out there, former superintendent. She worked with Mike, I guess, 7 years. And I'm really surprised that she came to see you, Mike.
There's nothing on TV.
I think that's an indication of the respect that people have for you and the love they have for you. I think that words have all been said tonight from our colleagues on the board, and I think that they realize your contributions, and we realize that, and I know the parents in the community realize it also. And Mike, I know you'll be doing the football thing again on the fall, and I wish you'd get the names of the kids right.
That's right.
Are they going to pay you next year?
But again, thank you, Mike, for a wonderful 9 years. And we've had a lot of fun, and there'll be a lot more fun. And I know that whenever we have a citizens committee formed or something, you'll be the first one to reach out for because of your expertise and knowledge in the district and the history of the district. Is there any other old business at this point? Any general board comments or new business? Public participation? Here she comes. Name and address, please.
I did come tonight, Mike, because this was your last meeting, and I wanted to be here to thank you and congratulate you on a very distinguished career as a board member. It was an honor to have you as a board member. Montville is blessed with a solid group of outstanding board members, but you are truly unique, and there were so many times where your institutional knowledge was so helpful to me as superintendent. I could give many examples, but the one example that I will give is when we went through the rebranding process and we were talking about the logos and the insignia, and you knew all of the meanings, all of the symbolism, and you walked us through that, and that was so helpful to us. Something that very few people could have possibly shared. I, too, as other people have noted, enjoyed your sense of humor, particularly as we went through some difficult times. The fact that you could
break that tension and bring some relief to us through that. People don't know how much Mike has given. You probably know as board members, but just his total commitment to the role of board member. And you will be missed. There is definitely something that will leave when you leave the board. But I wish you all the best, and I thank you for giving me the privilege of working with you for 7 years.
Thank you, Renee. Anybody else would like to speak?
Scott. Thank you. Good evening. Scott Riotto, Roxbury resident, MTHS history teacher, MTEA president. As has always been the case for the nearly 30 years that I've known him, Mike O'Brien is an impossible act to follow. I first met Mike in September of 94 when I came to Montville, and for some reason that I did not understand then, and I still do not understand now, he insisted on calling me Gary. And even after Mike retired from the history department, I continued to call the new guy Gary. And so if that doesn't make any sense, I don't know that it's really supposed to, but the tradition continued. Thank you, Mike. To the board, to everybody in the room, on behalf of myself personally and the entire association, I wish you all a very happy, healthy, and safe holiday season. I look forward to working with you in 2023.
Thank you, Scott.
Just in response to Mr. Riotto, the most recent Gary called me this weekend to get some information about the school district.
So I heard.
So there is still Gary.
Is there nobody else?
One more. John Petrosino. Just to ditto everything else that everyone said, thank you, Mike. And to make one thing that he said to me privately, I'm going to make it public. He offered me your help out of Montville Bay, and we were both campaigning, and I certainly accept it, and I hope you speak more very much in the future. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And good luck. Well, I guess it's that time, the last meeting of the year. We wish, on behalf of the board, at least on my behalf, I wish everyone a happy holiday season. Our next meeting is on January 3rd, next year. Sounds a long time away, but it's only a few weeks. And really healthy, happy, healthy holiday season for all of you and your friends and your family. I'd entertain a motion to adjourn, please.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you very much.